Since the success of his hit single Go, Moby's name has become a byword for intelligent dance music, techno or otherwise. Very pleased to have you in the studio with us today. The track that kind of really established you was Go, which sampled heavily from Twin Peaks. What inspired you to lift that piece of music?
The first time I ever saw Twin Peaks and I heard that piece of music, it affected me very strongly. And I figured out how to play it on my keyboard. So for the next 6 months, I was just fooling around with it. And then I was remixing Go. It was like an original version of Go, which is really minimalistic and doesn't have any strings or anything. Mm-hmm. And I started playing the Twin Peaks theme on top of it. And it worked. So, and I expected maybe at most to sell like 3,000 copies, 4,000 copies.
Did you have any feedback from Lynch?
Yeah, he wasn't too thrilled with it. But the guy that wrote it, Angelo Badalamenti, really liked it.
Because he was actually inspired by David Lynch. He commissioned the piece, didn't he?
Yeah. But David Lynch is surprisingly like a really tight businessman. Like, he's a lot different. You'd expect him to be some sort of freewheeling, spontaneous, creative person, but he's like surrounded by his lawyers.
You've just done a new deal with Mute for the world, and you're on Elektra in the States. You've got new material coming out. Is it going well?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, it's hard to tell because I'm in New York and it's all happening here, so I get these, you know, really encouraging phone calls that could be true or could be people winding me up.
You live in New York, but your fame seems to be in the UK and Europe, really. Yeah, does that upset you?
Not really. I mean, because America's much more of like a rock and roll country. Whereas England has a much stronger dance tradition, which it wouldn't seem that way, because a lot of dance music, you know, people think originates in America, but really it originates in the inner city, and most of America is still corn-fed white folks living out in the middle of the country.
Will they ever learn to dance?
I don't know. It's really hard to tell, because the major label record companies have such a stranglehold on the industry that, like, anything independent or strange coming up that doesn't have their blessing isn't going to get to your average Joe in the sticks.
You caused quite a furore at the Mix Mag Awards at the Albert Hall last year when, during your performance, you kicked the keyboards off its stand and smashed the mic up. Is that the real Moby in action there on stage?
It seemed like a lot of the dance music represented there was just all showmanship. Mm-hmm. And to me, dance music is supposed to be subversive and sexy and confrontational, and it wasn't.
So your philosophy seems to be that, you know, dance music should be subversive, sexy, make a statement. Where does the influence for that come from?
You know, when I first got exposed to dance music, because I grew up with, you know, very conventional upbringing, you know, white, middle class, played in rock bands, whatever, and then...
In the New York area?
Yeah. And then I sort of had this experience when I went to a nightclub in New York, and there are all these, you know, people of different racial backgrounds dancing to this music. And my eyes were opened and
converted.
That was it. I was converted.
Thank you.
music, instrumental dance music, if it's open to, you know, interpretation. But at the same time, I think that there are a lot of issues that need to be addressed. And I think we live in really in troubled times where, you know, the environment's messed up, the way people treat each other is messed up, the way people treat themselves is messed up. And I think it would be nice if there was more responsibility on the part of artists addressing those things.